What's up, everyone? We're back with another tutorial in Cubase Elements 8. We're going to do a basic beat making introduction right now. So without any further ado, let's just jump into it. In order to make a beat, a good tool to use that's included with Cubase Element 8 is the instrument called Groove Agent SE. So you want to add an instrument track. And there it is. You don't need this. This is for an individual who doesn't have a MIDI controller and they just need to write in the notes in MIDI with their mouse. That's what this is going to focus on. So, step one, hot tip number one. If you're going to be editing, and let's just make four bars here, and if you hit the Alt key, you can't see it with what I'm doing because of my screen recording software. But your cursor will become a pencil and you can draw in MIDI bars. And that's a helpful tip to know, and we'll be using the Alt key when we program the drums as well. So, we go in and you see this piano roll. And the piano roll stinks. It totally stinks to edit drums on. So you don't want that. What you want to do is here in your track inspector, where it says no drum map right here, you want to click on that and click Create Drum Map from Instrument. Oh, but we need to choose an instrument first. So I'll just choose Hip Hop Kit 01. That's fine. And Groove Agent is smart enough to make a drum map of Hip Hop Kit 01. So we have our drum map set up. Tip number two when you're programming drums is work in loops, whether it's 2-bar or 4-bar or 8-bar loops. It is very helpful. So you want to, I created 4 bars here, and you want to set up your markers around it, and you want to loop it. So make sure that's purple, either by clicking on it or hitting the divided by key on your keyboard. But then it'll loop that section. So now that we have our drum map set up, we have the 4 bars that we're going to work with for a loop, and we have it looped, we can get in and start screwing around. So, keep our click on. Actually, we don't need it. So here's another hot tip. Control equals and control minus will change your quantize setting, which is nice to be able to do quickly. So if you want a 16th note roll, you go to 16th. If you just want to make sure that everything's on a straight quarter, you know, it's nice to have those hotkeys instead of constantly clicking up and down. So those are good ones. Hotkeys for the view of the drum set, Shift H and Shift G, make it bigger and make it smaller. So there's some hotkeys. So we want to start with that C kick. We can see all the drums here. C1 kick, and we can hear it by placing in a note. And again, I'm using the Alt key. So if you hold down the Alt key, it becomes a pencil. I'm not sure if you can see it. Also, a quick note, I'm not routing the sound out from Cubase because when I do programming like this and I have the screen recorder going and it's trying to, you know, route the output from Cubase into the screen recorder, my computer gets angry. So if it sounds like crap, it's just because you're hearing a microphone through the monitors. But it's not about, you know, delving the sonic depths this tutorial. It's about sort of the technical aspect of making a beat in the drum editor. So, you have a kick on the 1. Nice. Maybe a snare on the 2 and 4. That sounds like a reasonable thing. Let's hear that. Alright, well, what if we move this up 1? That's starting to sound like a beat. So here's a quick tip. You can lower the velocity, and it would be more if you were working with acoustic drum sets, something like ghost notes. It just makes it sound a little more realistic. So you'd add a ghost note here. But ghost notes in hip hop aren't really a big thing. So you have a bar here. You can just copy and paste that. And what I do is I select them all, I hit Control C, I go to the next bar, I hit Control V. So it's already copied, Control V, Control V. So now you're starting to have what looks like a beat. There's the first bar. And then you want a little fill at the end or accent, you can just add 2 of these or whatever. So it'll sound like this from the beginning. That's starting to sound like an old school hip hop beat. So the next thing I think that we can focus on is hi-hats. I don't know if this set, you can see here the hi-hat open, hi-hat closed. So I like that one better. I'm not sure if this one automatically closes it. It doesn't. So on a lot of sets, when you do the close hi-hat, it'll. That's fine. So we can do that every other or something. And then maybe a shaker or something. I don't like that, so let's just set. Switch this out, do that, and then do our shakers right here on the one. And then move these two. Oh, and a helpful key, if you hold down Alt and you go across, you get all of them. And then this is your velocity control down here. So you can have it, you know. That's helpful to know, helpful to use. So we have, I don't know if we have a hi-hat pattern we like, but it is a hi-hat pattern. And maybe we should make them quieter. And let's just start copying and pasting. And that's the way that you make music in the modern era, is copy and paste. Copy, paste. Copy, paste. Copy, paste. All right, so it's starting to take shape. And maybe on this fourth one, instead of those ju-ju, we do a boom. I think what this beat needs is more cowbell. So I want to put cowbells on every quarter. So I switch my quantize with the control minus to quarter notes. Let's hear. The cowbell 2 is clearly the better cowbell. That don't even sound like no cowbell. So we'll just. And that's super loud, so we'll make that quieter with the velocity control. And here's what it sounds like. I think would like to do eighth notes. Bap, bap, bap. No, that's gonna have to be sixteenths. Let's try that. There So there, in a few short minutes, you have a beat. I mean, it may not be the type of beat that you're looking for, but it gives you the fundamentals of programming in the drum editor. You can use eighths, sixteenths, quarters, and you can start putting in triplets if you want to spice things up a bit. So here we are at 16th note. Let's do eighth note triplets. So if I wanted snare 2 to chat, 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 chat. Yeah, And then without a drum set or anything, just our mouse and our Alt key and clicking away, we have ourselves a workable drum beat. I hope this helps. Have a great day. Bye.